Hello everyone, welcome to lecture series of operating system. Today we are going to see the cell programming concept. Here let us see what is a cell. It is a collection of Unix commands and is called as a cell script. In an operating system, cell script is common word and is nothing but the weakly or loosely typed programming. There are no rules to have the some particular syntax. In a cell, we can do or execute all commands into a file, and standard cell is nothing but bound cell. There are different type of the cells. One of the cell is a bound cell, second C cell, and third one is a con cell. A cell can be used in one of the two ways. First way is that is command interpreter used interactively. We can execute a single command at a time. And the second way, a programming language which are used to write the cell scripts in our own custom commands. So this is a cell script. This is a file containing cell commands but with a few extra commands. Let us see the examples by implementing the commands. We can open the terminal and let us see one by one those commands. So by using the echo command, we can have the display of particular cell. Suppose I give the echo $0, it will display the related cell. So like this, the bash by is a by default cell in operating system, and some executed commands can do with the programming. So we can create a separate file. Here in a file we can use the variable types, and the variables are in a two ways we can use, that is a system defined and user defined. When you coming to the scripting, here no header files required and also no library files required. So it is called as a weakly or loosely type of the programming. Let us have the declaration of some variables. For example, I declare x equal to 30 or 60 something. So by using this echo command, echo is a similar to printf. If you know the C programming, you can have the printf statement that will display the variable or content of the variable. Here I can use a echo $x. So this is a displaying the content of the variable x. Suppose I want to create a file, new file. So we have the syntax vi and the name of the file which has an extension .sh for the cell. So this is the editor where we are going to add the some programs. I will write a simple message display statements. So I will write echo, then writing a messages. This is used just as a printf statement similar to printf. So we have a syntax like this. First program in a cell script. So I will run this program. So I will first save this. Escape shift colon WQ is used to save the file. So we can run this file by using the syntax sh, the file name .sh. So this is the output for simple first message display program. Suppose we want to take an input from the user. So that can read the input by using the statement or command that is a read. So I will write again or modify that program. I will write here command read. Read A, then read B, then echo, I will save this program. So we can run this program again. So here the inputs can give here for the variable A and variable B. So this is just whatever the inputs we have taken, that is displayed as a, with those commands. So now I am writing a program for arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, division, multiplication. So I will create another program, another file, that is so there we can write a separate program. So here echo enter first program. Then we have the command read, so we can take the input from the variable. Enter second variable. So in the first line I should write the first number, so you can assume that. Enter the second number. So take a second input by using the command read B. Then we have a arithmetic operations like echo sum of two numbers. Here we can write the calculation with the dollar symbol. In a square bracket we can give A plus B into the first number, into the second number. So the sum of two numbers equal to 10. Similar way we can do the remaining operations like subtraction, division, multiplication. So I will modify that program. So the next operation, that is echo subtraction of two numbers. So that is again followed by the dollar operator. So the variables a minus b. Then next statement, that is a multiplication. Multiplication of two numbers. That is again followed by the dollar symbol, square bracket, a into b. Then another statement for the next operation, that is this is how we have done the program in a simple way. So we can save and run this program. So we can have the first input, second. So this is a output for the given input numbers. So the sum of two numbers, subtraction of two numbers, multiplication and a division. So this is how the simple statements in a script programming. So let us see the control statements, that is for loop, if conditions, in a next video lectures. So thank you for watching. And do the comments below the video if any required, or give the suggestions if any modifications required. Thank you so much.